There are three components of the electric field and three components of the magnetic field, so we usually write both in terms of a three-component vector, E and B. This makes sense because the electric field can extend in three independent directions, X, Y, and Z, and the magnetic field can curl around each of those three directions. So from this, we would assume that for a different number of dimensions, let's say D spatial dimensions, there would also be D electric fields and D magnetic fields. However, this naive conclusion is wrong. In this video, we will show you exactly how many electric and magnetic fields there are in any number of dimensions. Let's start by considering Maxwell's equations. If we write them down like this, we immediately see the first problem. How does the cross product work in dimensions other than 3? So let's use a different formulation of Maxwell's equations, which is relativistically covariant and does not use a vector cross product. These two tensorial equations make use of the electromagnetic field strength tensor, F mu nu. With lower indices and in units where the speed of light is 1, the components of this tensor are the components of the electric and magnetic fields. As you can see, for 3 plus 1 dimensions, we have 3 E fields and 3 B fields. Now we can imagine higher dimensions. For D spatial and 1 time dimension, we have D plus 1 times D plus 1 entries in the field strength tensor. Regardless of which dimension we are considering, it has still to be an antisymmetric tensor. Therefore, the diagonal entries are all zeros. Then the entries here and here are the electric fields, and all those entries are the magnetic fields. From this, it's easy to see that there will be D electric fields, one for each spatial dimension. So what about the B fields? In here, we have D times D entries. But we have to subtract D since all diagonal entries are zero. And then we divide by 2, since the tensor is antisymmetric. If we know the upper half, then we automatically know the lower half. This results in D times D minus 1 over 2 magnetic fields. If we are feeling fancy, we can denote this as D choose 2. Let's check this for D equals 3, and we really get 3 electric fields and 3 magnetic fields. Now, what about other dimensions? Take a look at this table where we wrote down the number of E and B fields in several dimensions. The number of B fields seemed to follow a strange pattern. But it's not that strange if we think about it. In the beginning of this video, we mentioned that there are 3 B fields since there are 3 axes it can revolve around. However, that's not actually the case. In truth, there are 3 B fields because in 3 dimensions, there are exactly 3 planes in which the magnetic field can rotate: the XY plane, the YZ plane, and the XZ plane. If you look at it this way, the numbers do make sense. In 2 dimensions, there is only the XY plane, therefore only one B field exists. And in 1 dimension, we do not have any plane at all. And in 4 dimensions, where we might have one additional axis called W, there are 6 planes, and therefore 6 components of the magnetic field. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.